The soothing sounds of the harp have mellowed human beings for centuries. Great paintings depict angels strumming their heavenly lyres. They do.
But there's always someone ready to shatter the image. Leave it to John Pronk to find them in tonight's Texas Tale.
As you look around this Bedford strip mall, it looks pretty ordinary. You can join the Marines, buy some H2O, grab a mouth-watering burger, or buy a harp. A harp? Not only buy one, but learn to play it.
It's exciting, especially at my age, to start such a new adventure. It's like, ooh!
And then a C chord down there.
Geoffrey Ricketts owns Harps of Avalon. In the past 10 years, he's taught dozens of folks how to strum these ancient stringed instruments.
When I hear a student make that breakthrough between playing individual notes and actually playing a piece of music, it usually brings a tear to my eye.
Geoffrey studied music at the University of North Texas and played rock and roll guitar on the side. But when he took up the harp, he had to give up rock music. Or did he?
When I first got the interest in the harp, I started trying a few Beatles tunes and some Elton John, and I realized that it worked fine.
They call themselves Dream Plane, and they are as rock and roll as can be.
The other part is the B.
Even though they feature a classical trained harpist on the electric harp.
That's kind of unusual. It's something you don't see every day, that's for sure.
All these fellows have day jobs, but band practice is a chance to order a pizza, drink a few beers, and make music, some of it original.
Harp should be a fun instrument, and so many people make it so serious, and I'm having a great time with it.
John Pronk, Channel 8 News, Tarrant County.
I don't think that I've seen any paintings depicting the harp with some rock music.
No, I think that would be a new one on everybody, except for those guys, obviously. We thank you for joining us tonight.
We'll see you again tomorrow.